Today we are going to do a poem "To a Butterfly" by William Wordsworth. Now this poem is a very very famous poem of William Wordsworth. Now William Wordsworth is a very big name in English literature for his writings, and most of his poetry are based on nature. He used to feel that nature is the most peaceful place, and observing the minute details, the plants, the insects, the animals, the sun, moon, everything, there's some lesson to learn from them. So he has tried to express all his feelings through his poems based on nature. So here there is a poem about a butterfly. Now if you read this, then you will understand that something very common. It's a very very common sight, especially in summers. You will see, even in spring, these big butterflies, usually the black butterflies with the yellow spots, or the only yellow butterflies are garden butterflies. They sit on the flowers, and only if you touch them, then they move. Otherwise there is no movement. They can be there for very very long time. So we just see them and pass away, right? Have we ever tried to stop there and think that can we remain such motionless even if there is disturbance around us? Motionless here means calm, not getting disturbed, not taking any stress, and enjoy the nature, the beauty, or the life. So first I'm going to just read this poetry out to you before I explain. To a Butterfly by William Wordsworth. I have watched you now a full half hour, self-poised upon that yellow flower, and little butterfly indeed, I know not if you sleep or feed. How motionless, not frozen seas, more motionless, and then what joy awaits you when the breeze hath found you out among the trees and calls you forth again. This plot of orchard ground is ours. My trees they are, my sister's flowers. Here you rest your wings when they are weary. Here lodge as in a sanctuary. Come often to us, fear no wrong. Sit near us on the bough, we'll talk of sunshine and of song. And summer days when we were young, sweet childish days that were so long, as 20 days are now. So this is how the poem goes. So let's understand what it means. So here I is the poet, William Wordsworth, and you can understand that he is in a garden. He is watching a butterfly. So he says, I have watched you now a full half hour. Means for the last 30 minutes, this butterfly is sitting on a flower, and the poet is going on looking at it, trying to understand what it is doing. When will it fly? Self-poised upon the yellow flower. Self-poised means sitting gracefully, sitting very beautifully. Where? On the yellow flower. And little butterfly indeed, I know not if you sleep or feed. So he is telling the butterfly, little butterfly, it's a small butterfly. And I know not means I cannot understand whether you are sleeping or you are feeding. Now butterfly, you know what they feed on? They have this long tubes with which they suck the nectar, the sweet juice from the flowers. How motionless, not frozen seas, more motionless. So how motionless means he is most surprised that in spite of everything going around the butterfly, it is not moving. It is motionless. There is absolutely no movement in the butterfly. He is using the word twice. You can see emphasis is on the motion of the butterfly. not frozen seas, means usually the sea water is not calm, right? But when it is frozen in winter, then it doesn't move. It becomes motionless because it solidifies. So he is saying that even there maybe there is some kind of motion, but not the way you are sitting. What joy awaits you when the breeze hath found you? Out among the trees and calls you forth again. So he feels that the butterfly will experience a very joyful moment when the breeze will blow. Because when there is a strong breeze, you will notice that the butterflies just fly off and then again come back. So hath found you means has found you. That's an old English word. And calls you forth again means again after the motion of the wind is gentle, it calls you back to sit on the flower. Now the second stanza, this plot of orchard ground is ours. So he is telling the butterfly, you can see he is constantly actually talking to this butterfly which is sitting on the flower. So he is saying this area, this plot of the garden, orchard means a fruit garden, is ours, means belongs to his family. My trees they are, my sister's flowers. So he is saying all the trees are mine, I have planted them, and all these flowers which are growing, they are my sister's. Here rest your wings when they are weary. Here lodge as in a sanctuary. So he is saying the butterfly, he is telling the butterfly that weary means very tired. So whenever you feel very tired, please come here and take rest. Rest your wings. But how does a butterfly move? It keeps on flapping its wings. So when you are tired of flying, you are always welcome to come and take rest here. Here, lodge as in a sanctuary. Lodge means stay. As in a sanctuary, you know, they are protected areas. There are many sanctuaries around the world. Some are famous for tigers, some for lions, some for elephants, some for just wild animals, some for crocodiles, some for birds. Even there are sanctuaries of butterflies, where you go that you will find only butterflies. And they are protected means a human being specially cannot kill them or disturb them. So the life becomes very peaceful for them. So he says that feel as if you are in a sanctuary. Sit near us on the bough. Bough means the branch of the tree. We'll talk of sunshine and of song and summer days when we were young. So what story he wants to tell the butterfly? He wants to share with the butterfly the stories of his younger days with his sister when they used to sit in this orchard during the hot summer days and keep on talking about different topics. So he's saying, this poet is actually reminded of the old memories of his childhood. So he's saying that if you come here and rest, then I'll tell you these stories. Sweet childish days that were as long as 20 days are now. So he feels that one day was like 20 days. They were childish days. He enjoyed all those days of his childhood because it was full of fun, full of good memories, full of good experiences. So the moment he sees the butterfly in the garden, all those memories come back to the poet's mind. Now you see, the main point in this poem or the central idea is the butterfly's message that is being conveyed to us. That is one attribute of the butterfly, to be motionless. Now what happens, as I said in the beginning, that we as human beings get very disturbed most of the time. When things don't go the way we want, or sometimes somebody has been rude to you, you cannot forgive or say sorry or anything, then we are all the time disturbed. So it's really something to be admired in a butterfly, that in spite of the breeze, in spite of the sun, it is focused on its work. It's very calmly sitting on the flower and doing its job. If it is resting, then it is resting. If it is feeding, then it is feeding. If it is sleeping, then it is sleeping. There is no disturbance in that butterfly. And he also wants to say this calmness in the heart, calmness in the mind comes when we are connected to the nature. Now these days we see a lot of pollution in the nature being disturbed, the trees being cut. So many things are happening and we are getting more and more disconnected from the nature, which is harming the human life in different ways. So it's a short poem but very meaningful. Now we will take this poem up as a project. Okay, so I'll be sending you the details, and it is very interesting, you know, to find out the life cycle of a butterfly. Some of you must be knowing that there are these caterpillars which lay eggs on the leaves, right? And after that there is a soft covering, then the hard covering which is called the pupa, so the eggs rest there. And then after a certain period of time, out of those pupa, we don't get a caterpillar, but we get a butterfly. Meaning to say that if a fish lays egg, then a fish will be born out of it, isn't it? But here from these caterpillar, they lay eggs and a butterfly comes out. And sometimes these caterpillars, they don't look very beautiful. They are creepy, sometimes they are very hairy, sometimes they are very poisonous. But when a butterfly comes out of it, you see the butterflies are so colorful and so beautiful. If you just see a butterfly in the garden, you will keep looking at it because of its colorful wings and the way it flies over the flowers and keep on moving in the garden. So we'll be doing the life cycle of the butterfly, then we'll make a paper butterfly and find out some informations about butterflies. The biggest butterfly, what is its name, the smallest butterfly, where are they found, what kind of weather the butterfly is like. So find out these informations and then I'll send you a template. Template means a framework with what to write or do on those pages. So you will do that. So I hope the poem is very clear and there are hardly any hard words here to understand. So just in brief, again I'll do the recap. We have the poet sitting in his garden. It's not a garden, it's actually an orchard, a fruit garden, and he's sitting there and watching motionless the butterfly and trying to understand whether the butterfly is sleeping or eating. But he is mesmerized, he is just cannot think that how a butterfly can sit without movement for half an hour. Even when the wind comes, it tries to remain motionless, and if the wind is strong, it's flying away and then again coming back and sitting. So he is also inviting the butterfly to again and again come and sit in his garden to take rest. And it reminds the poet of the old childhood days when he and his sisters would play in the garden. They used to enjoy, they used to have a lot of talks as brother and sister. So he tells the butterfly that if you come and sit here, I'm going to share a lot of stories with you. So this is called personification. That means a butterfly is being compared to a human being. Human attributes are given. Why? Because a butterfly cannot speak, a butterfly cannot hear, right? But the poet is considering it as a human being and talking. And there are a lot of comparisons also here in between, you know, like the motion of the butterfly is compared to the frozen seas. So these are called poetic devices, means some structure of language which makes the poem more attractive, which creates images in the mind of the reader and makes it very interesting. So I stop here today. Thank you.